There we go. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Thursday. It is Thirsty Thursday. Do you know what that means? I hope you're hydrating. That's right. I hope you're hydrating. I've got a cozy koozie, whatever you call those things, on my water so it doesn't sweat all over my papers here. Going through all of my stuff and getting ready to go. I see a couple of people coming on. When we get to a certain magical number, I'll start talking about this free little book that you can win. There's Sherry from Texas. And there's my friend Marla, my body clutter buddy. We've been talking a lot of body clutter. We've been doing a lot of flights. I'm going to share with you my secret counting devices here. There's Fawn. Thanks, Fawn, for sharing. When you share, you care. What can I say? And when you send me love, it just lights me up. I love being loved. But we're talking about some habits and some different things that we do. There's Brenda and Kathy's here. Hi, Kathy. She's in my back to take back your body group. Vicky, hello. Hey, everybody. Good to see you all. Autumn, good to see you too. It is a beautiful day. I'm sitting here right now with this cool air coming in from outside. From outside. We do not have the air conditioning on. We have the ceiling fans on, and it feels fantastic. So anyway, I'm always so glad when you don't have to have the air conditioning on, because the air conditioning, you're either too hot or too cold. I don't ever know how to get that thing just right, but such is the way of air conditioning. So today, let's just talk a little bit about what we've got going on. There's another. We've got the Brendas in. We always manage to get at least two or three Brendas on. I don't know. Somebody can tell me what that's all about. But keep sharing and keep caring. Keep telling your friends to come on by. We are all about helping people to save dinner. And we bring people back to the dinner table one healthy meal at a time. That has been our mission since day one. This is what we do. And when we do that, we are helping people out of the chaos that comes with having a family. I mean, families take a lot of work, don't they? It's just never super easy, super simple. But the point though is if you are raising a family, or even if it's just you, or just you and your significant other, or whatever it is, you still need to eat. So getting dinner on the table is a big, huge deal. And we have, with Dinner Answers, which is our proprietary program, we have a code that will get you $20 off. So you want to know what that code is? It's back to school. That's it. Just put that on when you're checking out, and you're going to get $20 off. It'll be $77 for the year instead of $97. And you'll get bonuses galore, all kinds of things that you can use in your house. And you also get the auxiliary book. That's what we've been calling it, the auxiliary book, whatever that is, for body clutter. So that's just kind of some updates on there. There's some intermittent fasting stuff on there and anything else that you might find that you need. So just letting you know what we have there. So this is Thursday is Thirsty Thursday, and I'm going to either make smoothies or talk about different things that are, super helpful. And one thing you should know, that when you do get our protein, which I have over here, I'm not going to get it out and show it to you. But when you do get our perfect paleo protein, which comes in chocolate, vanilla, and unflavored, which I use because I like unflavored, it's flexible. I can add a little thing of stevia, I can add chocolate to it, I can add vanilla to it, I can do whatever I want to it. And it's just fantastic and ready to go. We send a free ebook that goes with that. Did you know that? You get tons of recipes. So you're not just stuck doing my gross, green, sludgy looking, slimy green smoothie that I make. Now, just because you can look at that and go, "Ooh, that's disgustingly, and how can you possibly drink that?" I'm hardcore. I've been doing smoothies for 20 some odd years with my kids. So, I do hardcore smoothies, but I know fruity berry smoothies with bananas and chocolate and all kinds. Yeah, those are delicious. And you can make them. And I don't say no to them. I'm just telling you what I do to get the extra going on. There's my girl, Tracy. Tracy's my newest NutriCoach student. I'm proud of her. And she's going to do some amazing things. I love what she's getting ready to do. Willow is here. So is Brenda, Barbara, Kathy. Look at Marianne. Man, you guys are all just like all coming in. I love that. We're 53 people so far. I love that. And you know, when you share, we throw down a book. That's right. We throw down a book. This week's winner is Annie Faith, and she claimed her book, so that's exciting. We have five books left. Five. And I'm going to give them out. So just all you have to do is be around on Monday so you can claim your book and share this video. Because what I do, I don't have it around, but I have a little tally sheet, and I write your names down, and I personally go through and I look and I say, wow, look at this. This gal, Annie, shared it like seven times that I counted. So if you share and you put it out on public, that's how I can see it. If you have your settings, whatever, but share it to the public, then that's how I can see it. And speaking of which, I've had a lot of people ask me, hey, I always get notified for Fly Ladies videos, but I never get notified for yours. How do I do that? I'll tell you exactly how to do it because I had to figure it out. So here's how you do it. You go in where underneath where you like the Saving Dinner page. And if you haven't liked the page, I don't know how you got here, but yes, you need to like the page, and there's a drop down, and then it'll say, you know, following, and click on the following. And then there's a drop down from there, and it says, get notifications. Check that box. Get notifications will get you my little thingy, and it'll come up and you'll see me going blah, 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 blah. And anyway, I would love that. So for sure you want to do that. And that's how you're going to get your notifications. Okay. Brenda's asking, is vanilla in stock? Thank you for that, Brenda. Vanilla has been ordered and it should be in stock late next week. We are constant. I just ordered it and you guys made it all sell out. Well, that's fantastic. But, you know, there you go. That's what's going on with that. So vanilla should be in stock. Chocolate is ordered as well. We got a bunch of stuff in order. So Helen, thanks for sharing. I appreciate that. And Kathy, you are right. I think green is delicious too, but some people just can't get over green. Okay. Kermit the Frog would be very upset with this. Kermit is my friend, and he like it's easy being green, is what he said. And see, Marianne just said she doesn't like that sweet stuff anymore. I'm kind of the same way. But you know, here's the thing that everybody's different. And if you are starting in on the smoothie journey, let me just tell you something. Our smoothie mix is so good. It's so good, non-dairy, but it tastes really creamy like whey. And if you add the right things, and you add enough ice and the thickness and the chocolate and everything, you can make it taste like a fast food shake. And that is the truth, right, Kathy? So I'm saying this to Kathy Cox because I know she uses it. It's delicious and it really makes a huge difference. Catherine, thank you also for sharing. So yeah, this is how we, you know, make things happen with our smoothies. And smoothies are a fabulous way to break a fast. And for me, that has meant that most days I have been able to do just two meals a day. And believe me, I'm sitting on a little extra body clutter. So being only at two meals a day, I'm not starving. Fasting isn't starving yourself. Okay, let's just put it out there. Fasting is a mindful approach to getting in touch with your hunger. That's what it is. That's what intermittent fasting is. When you get in touch with your hunger and you eat when you're hungry, it could run the gamut a little bit. So yesterday I got up and I was hungry, and I was hungry for about an hour, and then I was hungry for about 2 hours. And then I just said, you know what? I'm not going to get any work done unless I eat something, and I didn't want a smoothie. Sometimes that happens, even with me, the dinner diva who loves smoothies, the smoothie queen who even has a smoothie queen crown to go with that, right? No, sometimes you just have to have a scrambled egg or whatever it is that you have to have. And that's what you need to do. That is listening to your body, and your body is going to tell you things. If you listen to your body will tell you exactly what's going on. This is why I lecture you the way that I do and say that, you know, you have your own inner nutritional guru who is working on your behalf, who's telling you things that you need to know that are unique for your body, your situation, your place in this world, your height, your weight, your age, your gender, all the things. Wherever you are hormonally, it all plays into it, and wherever you are on that day. Usually, my normal routine is I'll break my fast with you at 1 o'clock. I'll have my smoothie. You'll see me drinking my smoothie. That's my first meal of the day. I break a fast with a smoothie. I like it because it's what? Let's see if anybody knows what I'm going to say. There's three things involved in it. Let's see if anybody remembers. I'm going to watch the comments and see if you can. And Brenda's asking, when is the best time to drink a smoothie? When you're breaking your fast. Because it's the first thing that goes into your body, and you can be extraordinarily mindful of those three things that need to go in there. What are they? Anyone? Let's see. How many carbs? There are no carbs in my smoothies. None. Unless I've got, you know, unless I'm adding a bunch of berries and stuff, but not. I don't see anybody, nobody has the answer yet. Are you glistening? Yes, a little bit. Can you tell I'm glistening a little bit? Yeah, I was going up and down the stairs, and so I kept having to take my glasses off and put them on. They'd fog up, taking them off, putting them back on. Does anybody know? There it is. Marla's got it. It's the target trifecta. The target trifecta is what we aim for with each meal. It's what we aim for also with our smoothie, especially with our smoothie, because the smoothie is the breaker of the fast. And that smoothie comes in with the exact protein we need, the exact fiber we need, and the exact fat that we need. And there's no carbs involved, you know, unless you're putting berries in it. But even so, the reason I use berries a lot, it's the low glycemic fruit, the lowest, and high in fiber. And so that all offsets. Fiber offsets the carb load. That's what happens. So what you can do is when you're looking at like total carbs, say it's 10 carbs and 8 grams of fiber, then you go 10 minus 8 equals 2 net carbs. And yes, that's how I count them. Okay? So just so you know, that's how I count them. So you want to keep your carbs really low, but you don't want to be doing it by buying a bunch of fake crap. There's protein powders out there that are horrible. They've got sucralose and they've got all kinds of stuff in it. Some of them are whey. And for some people, you know, you can look this up yourself. You can do a little searchy poo, Dr. Google or DuckDuckGo or whatever it is, however it is that you search Bing. You can look and you can find the studies that support that whey protein, especially for women that are a little older, like some of us are here, will help you gain weight. It's inflammatory. That's the problem. Dairy can be inflammatory. A little bit of dairy is fine for most people. Some people need to just step away from the dairy. When I was in full-blown rosacea mode, and you can't tell that now, my skin is pretty good. We can also thank our friends Dina and Jay for that because honestly, they're fantastic. But my skin is really nice. But at one point, I had red blotches and crusty skin all over from the rosacea. And I had to just step away 100% from all dairy for about, I'm watching the rain, by the way, come over the, right from the valley, right over. It's amazing. But I had that all over. And when I stepped away from the dairy and I did a bunch of other things too, and got my stress under control, it made a difference. It changed everything. My skin cleared up. This is what happens. Sometimes we just have to listen to what's going on with our bodies. You just can't, you know, be crazy like that. My friend Diane just joined. Good to know, Lucy says. And there's Dan. Hi, Dan. So, you know, what we have to always do is we just have to step back and we have to evaluate what's going on with us individually. Because we are uniquely and wonderfully made. Every single person is unique. Now, my ancestry, I'm mostly Irish and English. There is, when I was in Ireland, I will tell you, everybody was walking around with that slap cheek look. There was so much rosacea in Ireland. And I was like, there's my people, you know? And so we just need to be aware that people, you know, with my skin tone and what have you, and the freckles and the pink underlying skin tone, they're more likely to get rosacea. So if you're getting this kind of stuff and you're getting like these breakouts and this weird stuff, it could be an acne type rosacea, or it could be an out of control bacteria on your face, or, you know, they've even said it's mites. So, I mean, there's some controversy on that, but let's just go with this. you need to do a whole dietary recall and take a look at what's working for you. Take a look at what's not working for you. What you repeatedly do, you repeatedly become. We talk about that here in what our quote of the week is. And our quote of the week is, we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence then is not an act, but a habit. And as a matter of fact, if you look here on the Saving Dinner page, you can see we've put the quote of the week out, and you can print that off and have that for yourself. I love having quotes. They inspire me. They give me something to think about. I mean, even if I'm in bed and I can't sleep, I'll think about what my quote of the day was, because I want to go to bed always with a picture of something wonderful. And every night I have a picture of Marla and I doing some, we've got some really, really cool things. We have some cool things planned. And so, you know, I keep thinking about how wonderful that's going to be. Kathy Buck, love, love, love your show. By saving dinner, you have saved me. Oh my goodness, Kathy, you need to tell me about that. That's lovely. Thank you so much. Yeah, well, you know, Letitia, I hope I'm saying your name right. You said slack cheeks. That's what rosacea can look like. It can look like you have two red cherry cheeks, but it can also get to the place where it's rosacea, vulgaris, acne, or something like that, where it just gets crusty and it breaks out and you have these weeping business all over your face. I look like I had North America on one cheek and South America on the other. It was awful. The only person that saw this was Marla Silly. She's the only one that I took pictures and I sent them to. I was in tears. I did not know what to do. And there's a long story that goes with that, but we, you know, it did go away. And it's just, that was getting my diet. That's when I really started to pay attention. You would have thought I would have paid attention when I had the three huge nodules on my neck. No. It wasn't until my face was, you know, it's when your face is brought to the forefront and everybody can see something's wrong with you. Something's going on. And then I was thinking, nutritionist, heal myself, you know, figure this out. And so, you know, I did. I pulled out the gluten and I pulled, dairy was the first one, and then the gluten came off. And it all made a difference. And the gluten, especially, was what I felt in my hips. And my mother, that's how we saved her from having hip surgery. I made her for 1 month. This is an interesting story. My mother was 81 at the time. And she went to the doctor, and because she had this horrible hip pain. My mother was very tall, was my height, but very thin. She weighed about 118 pounds. And she would turn on her side and she would cry at night from the excruciating pain that she had in her hips. So she went and saw, you know, of course they're like going hip surgery, hip replacement. She went and saw the doctor and he said, well, you know, it is, you know, you have this inflammation going on in there and thin bones. She had osteoporosis. And, you know, he was like, we should just do hip surgery and just replace your hips. And she wasn't so keen on that. And I said, Mom, he said, I don't see this getting better. And I said, Mom, let's 1 month, give me 1 month. So I got her on the smoothies. I had her doing the smoothie a day. I had her with the trifecta. Let's break your fast with this. I pulled the gluten out and you would have thought I was asking her to give up her cats. She had these two big cats. And it was just, we had words on the phone and I was like, Mother, just do it. I'm asking for 30 days. I'm not asking for the rest of your life. Long story short, I gave her the diet. I gave her the protein. I got her all set up. Within 30 days, she was my biggest evangelist. She was out there and she heard somebody murmur or say something about being in pain. She said, no, talk to my daughter. She'll fix you up. She went back to see the orthopedist. When they did the scan on her, they said, well, everything looks a whole lot better. And he said, but I think we should still do the surgery. And my mother, anybody who knew her back then, and Marla did, she can tell you, she told that doctor where to go. She wasn't kind. And she never saw him again. The pain went away. Now, it did not cure her osteoporosis. She still had very fragile bones. It didn't, you know, but it took the pain out. It took the inflammation out. And that's what we're all about. It's about finding that place to get rid of the inflammation. Inflammation is the mother of all disease. It's the mother of chronic pain, of chronic everything. And let's just talk about it. You know, you get diagnosed with something. It isn't until you're in pain or visual whatever that you start to do something about it. I didn't do anything about those nodules that were on my neck until the rosacea came out. And it was all connected. The rosacea came out and got my attention. And that's what needed to happen. It was like God was saying to me, hey, Leanne, pay attention. Your thyroid is completely out of whack. You're getting all these humongous nodules on your neck. You can hardly walk across the room. You've got this stuff on your face. Do I have your attention now? And yes, he did. And yes, I changed things up. And it made all the difference in the world. And that's what I want for you. So to do this, we have something coming up. We have the sprint coming up. And it's the hot melt sprint. And it's using keto principles in a non-inflammatory way. And all you have to do to get the 7-day plan, which will start, by the way, on September 9th. So it's the Monday after Labor Day. The Monday after Labor Day. We will start September 9th. As a community, look at how well we do as communities. I mean, you're part of the Fly Lady, most of you anyway, are part of Fly Lady. If you don't know anything about Fly Lady, go to flylady.net right now. This will get your house in order. This is to me, is the bedrock and the foundational key to what started my whole career. If I hadn't gotten my house in order, I would have never done what I'm doing now. I wouldn't have a business that I've had for 19 years. I would have never started NutriCoach. This is what moved the needle. And that's what I'm trying to do here with talking nutrition. Foundationally, we move the needle when we start getting rid of the inflammatory stuff. And that's what the sprint is about. So we take in the keto principles without having to pee on sticks, without having to measure macros and micros and put apps on our phone. We take all of that stuff and just trash it. We know what to do, and I'll show you exactly what to do using these hot melt principles, using a specific formula that I've put together, and you don't have to buy anything. You just have to show up and do it, and we'll do it in community. We have a Facebook group already set up for it. We'll do it in community. We'll talk about it. We'll get charged up. We'll get support. We'll get encouragement, because all the studies, and I read 9 of them, 9 studies, that show that you are more likely to be successful on any kind of weight loss plan or any kind of a change that you want in your life when you're doing it in community. We need each other. We're people, you know, we're not hermits. We're not, you know, lone rangers over here. We're people. We need each other. We need family. We need somebody to know that they care. We need somebody to say, hey, don't worry. I'll be your buddy. I'll be your body clutter buddy. I've got mine. Do you have your body clutter buddy? Well, you have the opportunity to do this. You have the opportunity to find a body clutter buddy right here. All you have to say is, hey, I need a body clutter buddy, because it helps. You communicate back and forth. You hold each other to an account, and you know that person's got your back. As Marla says, if you want a friend, then be a friend. And this is a way to be a friend. Think about that. So, the quote of the week. I hope you are thinking about that, and I hope you're thinking about what your habits are, what your excellent habits are. Excellence, then, yes, it's a habit, not an act, and excellence has nothing to do with perfection. It has to wanting to do better is all. You know, we can all do better. It's not about perfection ever, because that beats you up. But being excellent and being proud of the job that you've done and saying that to your children and saying it to your spouse, everybody wants to be appreciated. Excellence is something to be appreciated. So, where am I? Q&A is on Friday. That's tomorrow. I already have about 6 questions, but you're more than welcome to put your questions in. I will only go for an hour tomorrow. Friday Q&As are faster, a lot faster. So just, or a lot longer rather. So just support at Saving Dinner. Send in your questions. And just, if you would, in the subject line, just put a question for Leanne for Friday, just so that my customer service team understands what this is about. Otherwise, they forward them to me, and I'm like, I don't know if I'm supposed to answer this or save it or whatever. But and the other thing is too, if you guys put your questions here, there's a chance I won't see them. We're still live and we're at 95 comments. How do you like that? So I just want to make sure that I see your question, because sometimes I can't come back and look at all these things. Also, we're saving these videos are all going onto YouTube. So if you know and you want to share these, you know, on YouTube with a friend who's not on Facebook, that's fine. There, you'll find them there. YouTube.com/savingdinner. So NutriCoach appointments. I have had, lots of NutriCoach appointments and lots of new students. And what my favorite are fly babies. And I'm going to tell you that right now, I'm so excited about that, because I know if you're a fly baby, you've already worked, you've done the work. You've done the foundational work of putting your house together, and then you have the vision for what you want next. So that's exciting. And, you know, as from one fly baby to the other, let's do it, sister. So if you go to NutriCoachSchool.com, I'll show you how to get your second act and how to have your own business. How exciting is that? Where are we? What else do I need to tell you about? Hey, what's for dinner, you guys? Do you know what's for dinner? If you don't know what's for dinner, you don't need to be freaking out. You just need to pull something out. Go to the freezer, pull something out. You can do a quick thaw. Get a big stainless mixing bowl and put whatever it is, you know, protein, usually that's what it is, that needs to be thawed. You can put it in hot water, not boiling water, but hot water. It's quick, it's fast, it's easy, and it's safe. Putting food out to sit on your countertop is not safe. That's not the safe way to thaw. The safe way to thaw is just what I told you. So do that, or else you do it a couple of days in the refrigerator. That doesn't always work. Look at all you guys here. Marianne says, yes, starting to fly with Fly Lady helps. Yes, it does. Taco salad tonight. I love that. Look at all of you guys. You're so busy. Somebody's looking for supplements. If you go to savingdinner.com, you'll see the whole little navigation bar, and there's a shopping tab, because don't we all like to shop? Go shopping. Every single supplement that I have there, every single one, and I think there's only 14 or 15, they're all chosen specifically by me. They've all been vetted. They're all pharmaceutical grade. Every single batch is tested for purity. And, you know, most supplements you can't say that with, because they're not regulated that way. So just know that when you're going, I'm stand behind them too. I stand behind absolutely everything. They have a reason for it. Brussels sprouts. Yeah. I love that. Grill hot dogs. But yeah, we have a little storm coming here, but it's just a sweet little storm. There's a no soda for me pledge. So, you know, we're talking Thirsty Thursday right now. No soda for me. If soda's a problem, get that out. That's the first thing you want to knock out. And go look for the pledge. It's right here. You'll see it in the pictures. Take that out. Share it with your friends. Print it out for yourself. Sign it. You know, make a contract with yourself that you're going to do better. When you know better, you can do better. And you know what soda does for you. There's no guessing game on that. And I'm talking all soda. The only, you know, anything that you could do with that is soda-ish would be a plain soda. But even so, do mineral water, even better, or some kind of a fizzy water, you know, just, but no soda. We don't need it, diet or otherwise. It's crazy. And sign up for our emails. Oh, by the way, the sprint will only be available via email. And every single day, you'll be getting a new email that'll give you a hint and help you to do it. We will have a Facebook community, yes. But the sprint itself is only available via email. So go to savingdinner.com. You'll get a free week of menus, and you'll automatically be on the list, and you will get the notification. You'll get the shopping list. You'll get the whole all the directions on what to do. And I've spent a lot of time on this, a lot of research on it. I've done it myself. It works, and it'll make you feel like $1 million. So that's it. That's all I've got for today. We have a few things that are on back order, but everything's ordered. So, you know, I can barely keep up with you guys. You guys are doing really well on the supplements. Supplement questions are questions that you can also submit, and I'll help you with. Okay. Because I think that is such a crucial, important thing. So that's all I have for you today. I really appreciate you showing up. And you know, at 3 o'clock, it's tea time. We're going to take a load off and go have tea with Marla at the Fly Ladies. So again, you know, we are the 1-2 punch here. We're getting it done. I'm glad you were here for your dose of nutrition and talking about dinner and what have you. Get your dinner menus made. Get with it. Stay with the program and plan it, because I promise you, your people are going to be hungry tonight. So why do something very last minute when you can right now stop what you're doing, run to the refrigerator or the freezer, pull something out and make a plan. Go to my site, savingdinner.com. You'll see a bazillion recipes. Let's make a pledge that we're going to get our meals on the table. They expect that. All right. You have a fabulous Thursday. Okay. Go make it happen. Bye.